Buenos dias. Mi amo, I am Dylan. Welcome back to Genshin Impact.
Hey, is that who Paimon thinks it is?
It's the weird, scary girl. Opera lady.
Yes, you are quite right. I shall take your wise words to heart, sir. They will certainly be most helpful in my next performance.
You are welcome, Miss Yun. Your willingness to hear suggestions is indeed impressive. It's no wonder your opera performance has only been getting better.
Ooh.
No, I'm afraid that's not always the case. Though I am still young, I can be quite arrogant at times.
Zhongli, we're back!
We just interrupt her like crazy.
Ah, you've returned.
I have.
Hmm? You are also acquaintances?
We're best friends! Get out of here!
Very well. Goodbye, Miss Yun.
Whoa.
See you around, Yunjin!
Are we viewing sometimes from people's eyes? Is that what it is?
So, tell me, what have you learned from your trip?
She's very busy all the time, man.
Paimon thinks we can use food as our theme.
No.
Who doesn't like delicious food? And when it comes
classic
to eating,
Paimon.
Everyone has...
Rest is always of great importance.
Rest is boring.
Although we may come across various difficulties in our lives.
But you have to do it, I guess.
Pushing ourselves is never a good modus operandi.
Sure.
Excuse me, Lady Keqing?
Hi, Keqing. Still working? Aren't we going to see the fireworks?
Oh, yes. But I thought we'd meet at the Jade Chamber. Why have you come here?
I find you!
Traveler and Paimon, let's go to the Jade Chamber. The view there is nicer and it's much more private. Perfect for talking.
Ooh.
What was it you wanted to talk about?
Spiders!
What do you say?
All right. I'm listening.
So it turns out we just heard some big news in Teyvat. A very talented chef is in trouble.
Oh, is the chef from Liyue? From Liyue Pavilion or Xinyue Kiosk, perhaps?
No, the chef is from Mondstadt, yeah, and he's really, really good. He had a restaurant right next to the city gate. He was super efficient, and his cooking was really delicious, so his restaurant had been getting more and more popular. In fact, he became so busy that the worker from the florist next door asked him, "Sir, why don't you find someone to help you in the restaurant?" But the chef brushed the idea aside, saying that he's the only one that can turn top-quality ingredients into world-class dishes. No one could help him.
Well, confidence is an essential trait for a good chef. He must be an excellent cook.
That's what everyone was saying. But surprisingly, after just 6 months, no one would dine in his restaurant anymore.
Why?
Shocking, right? Do you have any guess why?
He died!
Maybe the chef had fallen ill, or...
Wrong answer! You tell her, Traveler!
Do I have... You have stubborn.
Ding, ding, ding! Yep, it's because the chef was too stubborn. He would keep himself busy every day and try to make the most delicious dishes for all his guests. But he forgot that he's only human and needs time to eat and rest. He was so busy that he didn't even have time to eat and couldn't even taste his own cooking. He was unwilling to seek help, even when he's tired, because he thought he's the only one capable of cooking the best dishes. Eventually, the people around him felt like they couldn't help him anyway, so they just left. And because he had forgotten the original taste of his dishes, he was no longer a good chef. In the end, his restaurant had no choice but to close for good.
Unfortunate! Let's go to that restaurant.
I see. He's overly confident, which disappoints the people around him, and he's so impatient that he ends up losing sight of his original purpose. So, that's the whole story?
I guess.
Yep, that's the whole thing!
Sorry, it's not a very good story.
Hey! Paimon made a great story!
No!
Did you come up with that story?
Oh!
How should I describe it? The story is very simple, and I suppose the ending isn't really surprising.
Huh?
Think before you act and don't overexert yourself. Of course, I understand these concepts in theory, but when tasks come to me personally, it is easy to lose sight of the bigger picture. Yes. Up in the mountains, we can see the mist in the clouds. Out in the ocean, we can see fog on the sea. That's why, from time to time, we need to examine where we are, remove the fog, and feel our heart.
How do you feel now, Keqing?
Just jumps. Oh my gosh!
You? Deep down inside, I wish I could slow down time. That way, I could finally take the opportunity to walk around the city, see the people I wish to see, and watch the fireworks.
Take a break.
Thinking back, I used to be even more impatient. My colleagues would resign after just 3 months of working with me. You're completely right. It's important to know your boundaries.
Limits.
But I am getting better. You can tell, can't you?
Kinda.
I did make a promise with you, didn't I?
Paimon just kicks her off the side. She didn't understand the story!
We need to enjoy the fireworks show together this year. So, happy lantern right, Traveler and Paimon. I'm very happy to be here and enjoy this moment together with you.
Let's see some fireworks!
Lady Keqing, the item Lady Ningguang prepared for you has arrived.
Traveler, wait here for a moment. Don't go anywhere.
Huh? Must be something important.
Pretty! What is that, fish? Hey, the Fatui. What's up? Just wanna rob some people later? Heck yeah! This is a rock. This is a cool looking...
Can I look at the rock?
You can. Girl Tigerfish here.
Traveler? Paimon? Huh? Ningguang had her personal tailor make it for me. Said it's an imported style. Well, do you like it?
Wow! It's beautiful!
It's time. Traveler, please enjoy the grand finale of this year's Lantern Rite. The fireworks show.
Isn't it beautiful?
Just wearing all...
Hey, check you out. Looking pretty fancy.
Only a true treasure catches the eye of Captain Beidou. Seems I've struck gold with this one.
Shina. Shina. Yanfei! Ganyu!
Madam Ping!
So it does.
Tree.
Oh.
Dr. Baiju. Sorry to trouble you again this year.
No trouble at all.
Lantern right.
She's a zombie.
Happy lantern right.
As always, thank you for watching, and I will see you eventually.